Hey guys. We're in my bathroom, and the reason for that is today I'm going to be telling you how I care for my orchids. Most of my orchids, there are a few scragglers hanging around the rest of the house, but most of my orchids are sitting behind me on my windowsill here. I thought we'd join the orchids in the bathroom where they love, or seem to love. We'll get into that. Okay, so I'm not going to sit here and pretend that I'm an orchid expert. I'm definitely an orchid noob. The ones I have gotten since last July have been doing really, really well, have bloomed multiple times. So I do feel comfortable sharing my personal orchid care tips and tricks. I used to fear orchids. They intimidated the heck out of me, and I finally have done the thing. I think we've got them figured out. I will also add timestamps down in the description box that you can go to if you'd like to skip around section by section. I will be covering quite a few things in this video, and I hope you find it helpful. As always, please thumbs up or thumbs down this video, depending on what you think of this type of content. Leave a comment down below sharing your best orchid advice. I am looking forward to seeing all of your orchid care tips. Huge thank you to Function of Beauty for sponsoring this video. Everybody's hair is unique, and me's an example. My hair is super fine and thin, not very much volume. My scalp is kind of more on the oily side. This is why I love Function of Beauty so much. It's been really difficult to find a product that works really well for my specific hair needs. And Function of Beauty definitely has helped solve a lot of these issues. My hair has come a long, long way in the several months I've been using Function of Beauty. So my favorite hair goal that Function of Beauty has tackled is actually adding a bit of volume to my hair. Like I said, it's super fine and thin, kind of lifeless. I am definitely super happy with the results I've gotten so far. So Function of Beauty does actually customize the formula to your own hair needs based on the answers to the quiz that you take on their website. Kind of a bonus to the benefits that Function of Beauty has brought in my routine is the fact that their bottles are really cute. So they're actually customized to say Function of Harley, because I'm Harley. You also get to choose the scent. Since we are going into summer, I decided to go with the Takes Two to Mango scent, which is actually a new one to them, and I love it. In my set, I did decide to also get the leave-in treatment. I do actually add this to my dry hair if I'm going on second or third day hair between washes, and it helps keep it smelling nicer longer. You can get 20% off your first set when you click the link in the description box. So now is a great time to try out Function of Beauty. See what a big difference it can make for you, just like it has for me. Again, huge thank you, Function of Beauty. Let's get back into it. Category number one is the one I feel is most important, and that is watering. I do think watering is where I was going wrong in the past. I do also think this is something a lot of other people probably go wrong with as well, because there's a lot of wrong information online, and do not water your orchids with ice cubes, please. I know this is a very old orchid care hack, but actually this can be really detrimental to orchids, because the freezing cold water of an ice cube as it melts off can really shock the roots and actually cause a lot of problems down the line. Please don't water with ice cubes. Now, how to tell when your orchid is thirsty. The leaves of the thirsty orchid will begin to thin and feel a little bit of papery and like flimsy, really flexible compared to how they normally feel. Even more than that, if you keep your orchids in a clear pot, which I do recommend, I find it a lot easier. I only have a couple of mine in clear pots right now, but I think it's a really, really great way to keep tabs on your orchid root system and kind of see what's really going on. And then it's not so much of a guessing game as to when to water. If you keep your orchid in a clear pot, which I will link my favorite ones down in the description box if you want to pick some up for your orchids and maybe repot them in there, the roots will tell the whole story. So orchid roots, silver, wrinkly looking roots are thirsty, and green, lime green roots are well watered. I actually really love bottom watering, so I do actually keep my orchids in their nursery pot, or even better, clear pots, so that I can pull them out and see the roots, see what's going on, and then bottom water them. And I think bottom watering is one of the biggest ways I've been able to keep my orchids happy. If you think about where orchids live, it just makes sense to suck the water up from the bottom, like a river, to me and my orchids. Maybe you and your orchids are a little bit different, but that is definitely what I recommend. If you're checking your orchid roots and they look brown or black, kind of mushy, that means that you have overwatered the plant and it is suffering from root rot. So you're going to want to cut away those roots, kind of cut back on watering to try and salvage the rest of the plant. Again, I do bottom water, but I don't actually let my orchids sit in the water. So what I'll do the days I'm noticing they're thirsty is I will go ahead, give them a little bottom water dose, let them sit in that until I'm noticing the substrate soaking up and kind of getting wet at the top. Sometimes it's a few hours, sometimes it's a full day. I do recommend draining out any excess water. If you're maybe struggling with your orchids, it might be worthwhile to try out some of those watering tips because they've made such a difference for me and my planties. Look, it's blooming. How cute is she? Next section is substrate. So I do not plant my orchids in regular soil. Two substrates I will pot my orchids in are sphagnum moss, small piece orchid bark. So there are different sizes of orchid bark. I do prefer the smaller one. I will link my favorites for both of those again down in the description box. Most of mine are in the orchid bark, but you guys know how much I love sphagnum moss. So definitely not saying sphagnum moss isn't a great option as well. What's more important than deciding whether you're going to do sphagnum or orchid bark, in my opinion, is not potting the plant too far down in the pot. So if you're planting it too far down, the bottom leaves of the plant are going to end up rotting more often than not. So kind of my general rule of thumb is when I'm going to pot one of my new orchids, I will leave a little bit of the top of their roots exposed as well as the base of the plant so that the leaves aren't even touching the substrate. And that way I know they're not going to, you know, get wet, especially where I'm bottom watering. I don't have to worry too much about not getting the leaves wet since I'm dumping it in the water in a separate container and then it sucks it up. I do leave a solid inch or so exposed above the substrate to ensure that this doesn't happen. Lighting, I do actually keep every single one of my orchids on a north window. Every single one of them is on a north window. They do prefer bright indirect light. I have tried keeping them in super bright, like almost direct light in the past, southern light exposure, and they haven't done very well for me where I live. Maybe don't keep it in a south window, but I do think any other direction would be pretty good for orchids, especially east and north. Those would be my two picks for orchids. Bright and direct, they love it. Humidity, you will see on screen, I don't have my little reader right now, but you'll see on screen what the humidity is here in my bathroom. I do actually keep two of my micro orchids in a little terrarium where the humidity is quite high. It's about 70%. Those micro orchids do tend to like a little bit higher humidity, but generally speaking, most orchids, especially Phalaenopsis orchids that you find most often, for the ones you're gonna find pretty much, you know, just wherever you're out shopping, they are going to be very happy in 40 to 70%. Humidity. My bathroom is here on screen. It's definitely at the lower end of that because I live in a desert. It is so dry here. We have like 30% humidity outside. Your household humidity is going to be just fine for them. Maybe if you're getting into the more specialized orchids, keep it at the higher end of that spectrum. So yeah, regular household humidity is going to be just fine for them. You don't have to worry too much, especially for the orchids. You're finding at your big box stores and most plant shops. Not all, but most. A lot. Some, yeah. Now on to fertilizer, which is another thing I think I've made quite a few changes to my old killing off my orchids routine to my new keeping them alive and happy and actually reblooming routine. Number one, you guys already know how much I love Liquiter. I do have a 25% off code if you'd like to try Liquiter out. I know it seems expensive outright, but I promise you it lasts a long time. So I use Liquiter with every single watering. And they love it. Something new I've actually introduced to my routine for just my orchids and actually my hoya, that's a whole separate video, is orchid plant food. So I just use this Miracle-Gro kind. I don't have experience with any other kinds, although I'm sure there are better options on the market. This has worked really well for me. Every time I water, I do actually spray the orchids with this. When I'm spraying them, I'll really make sure to focus it on the exposed roots, you know, at the top of the substrate, the tops of the leaves, and then also the top of the substrate I'm using. And I'm really careful to not spray it on the flowers. Don't spray it on the flowers. The flowers won't absorb it and they don't really like this touching them. So yeah, just keep it at like more the base area of the plant and you'll be good. I do think this goes a long way in helping your plants to rebloom. Liquidert and this Miracle-Gro Orchid Plant Food Mix. Wait, ready to use orchid plant food mist. They love it, and again, I do this every time I water. The last section of this is blooms and how to handle blooms. So this is something, again, this is one of the most intimidating parts of orchids to me. So maybe I just wasn't paying very good attention or not listening very well, but I swear people always told me that once the orchid blooms, you know, blooms on the stalk, like what I have here, that I need to cut the stalk all the way back to the leaves. I swear that's what people were telling me, but that's not what you should do. Come to find out. Usually the first time that main stalk will bloom, the blooms will come out of the tip of that stalk. And the tip of that stalk will completely dry off once the blooms fall off. Although orchid blooms do last a long time, which is something I really love about them. Like, that's super unique. Like, Hoya blooms die so fast. Cactus blooms die pretty quickly in my experience. But orchids, you know, they stick around. They're here for the long haul. So that's a really nice aspect of them. They'll be here for weeks before they dry up. Anyway, once they dry up and fall off, usually the portion of the stalk where the leaf was will turn brown, completely like crisp up. It looks totally dead compared to the rest of the stalk. Instead of cutting the whole stalk down, you just want to cut where the stalk has died. Any of that brown bit, go ahead and chop that right off. You don't want to cut the whole stalk completely back because you'll see, as an example, my large one here, you can see it has actually pushed a new branch off of that main stalk. That first stalk that bloomed pushed out a little side shoot, and that's where it's blooming from this time. So if you're cutting the stalk back each and every time, it has to focus on regrowing that entire thing plus regrowing blooms. So it's going to take a lot longer for your blooms to form. That is to say, if the stalk dies all the way back, go ahead and cut it. Like, an example are my Paphiopedium. I think their common name is lady slipper orchids, have the one stalk with the one bloom. I just cut that back every single time the bloom dries out. So yeah, it will push a new stalk and a new bloom. And it they actually bloom quite frequently in my experience. You definitely don't wanna be cutting it all the way back, otherwise the plant has to push so much more energy and so much more time into creating a whole new stalk and a whole new bloom, starting from scratch as opposed to just that offshoot and the blooms, you know? I feel like that's another big tidbit of information that kind of goes around that typically is not true. I mean, it can be true if your stalk dies all the way back and browns all the way back, not always. And I would actually say more often than not, it doesn't die all the way back. Those are all my orchid care tips. I know some of you may be interested in seeing a full list of all my orchids in my collection right now. And I will have a video coming out in a few weeks with my full collection and individual names of orchids. Oh, that's kind of something, that's also something I should include. So I was told there is actually a specialty orchid shop near me, well, like an hour away from me in Salt Lake City called Orchid Dynasty, where half of my collection actually came from. The owner of that is super knowledgeable about orchids. If you're in Northern Utah anytime, I highly recommend checking them out. You do have to make an appointment to be able to go back and see the orchids. The owner does actually go through one by one with people to talk about the orchids, which is really cool. Something he told me I never knew before is orchids are crossbred so frequently. Different crosses can actually look really similar to one another. So it's critically important if you want to keep the value of your especially more uncommon orchids. I mean, I keep them for all of them. It's just better safe than sorry to keep the name tags with your orchids. If you lose the name tag, it kind of loses all value because it's very, very hard to ID them because the different crosses do look so similar. So be sure to keep the tags in your orchids. Kids, yay, okay. I will be posting a video of my orchid collection a few weeks from now. So once it's available, I will link it up here as well as in the description box if you'd like to watch that. All the products I've talked about in this video will be linked down in the description box if you want to try out anything for yourself that I personally use in my collection. And yeah, I look forward to reading your comments and seeing what you think of this video. I hope it was helpful for you. All right, so that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next.